Moving on to the fourth problem, I've solved already two problems. From now onwards, I'll not solve each and every problem completely. Rather, I'll be giving you some tips as how to solve the fourth problem. You can take down the instructions given and work by yourself and see whether you are able to reach the target, that is, you are able to accomplish the problem or not. Now, what you have to do is, as I say the item, you will be marking the items either as real account or personal account or nominal. You already have the idea. You can do it on yourself and then cross check with what I say. Now, once we have done with this, what we will do in the next step, we will discuss as we proceed. Now, salaries. So, in fourth problem, the first item on the debit side of your trial balance or a debit balances column is salaries. Salaries, nominal account, mark it N against it. Purchases, nominal account, mark N against it. Wages, nominal account, mark N against. So, here you will continue to mark N, P, R as I dictate. Then, carriage on purchases, nominal. Office expenses, nominal. Commission, nominal. Debtors, personal. Furniture, real. Machinery, real. Insurance, nominal. Bank balance, personal. Then, bills receivable, real account. Cash, real account. So, hope you are done with your RPN or whatever is the order. Now, you see that once you know that real accounts and personal accounts should come in balance sheet only. Since they are debit balances, you are going to take them on asset side. So, on the debit balances column, whichever you have marked as real and personal will appear on the asset side. Now, leftover are nominal. So, you are going to distribute this nominal between trading and P&L as discussed earlier. So, in trading, you know, that is opening stock purchases and direct expenses. Here you will be taking all indirect expenses. List of direct expenses already we have discussed. Refer to that if you have confusion. So that some direct expenses in this problem are, you have carriage on purchases, that is only exception which you might not find exactly in the list. Now, moving on to the credit balances of your trial balance. Again, you will be doing the same. You will be marking them as NPR. Or now, sales, nominal. Creditors, personal. Capital, personal. Bills payable, personal. So, you can see all are personal except sales. So, all personal accounts, you will be putting them on the liability side. Now, again, I repeat, capital, you have to take it in a column. And in this problem, since there is no purchase returns and no sales returns, you will be taking them directly in the outer column. Coming to the adjustments, you know, outstanding wages. The journal entry, if you remember, wages to outstanding wages. So, wages to be debited. So, add 2000 to wages and outstanding wages being personal account, write it on the liability side. If you refer the table, it stays the same. Add to wages and write it on the liability side because it's outstanding expense. Moving to the second adjustment, outstanding salaries. Again, refer to outstanding salaries, journal entry, that is outstanding expense journal entry or the table. It states that add to, it will, you will lead to the conclusion it should be added to salaries in P&L account. And since outstanding salaries personally, you will be taking it on liability side. Next item is prepaid insurance. It becomes prepaid expense. So, from insurance, you will be minusing the amount in P&L account and then again showing it in the balance sheet asset side. Next item is create 5% for reserve for bad debts on debtors. Create 5% reserve on debtors. Now, if you remember, if you refer the table, you will see 5% should be deducted from debtors as a provision and shown it on the P&L account debit side. The treatment is just like your depreciation. So, just I'll put it across because we have not done in the previous problems. So, let us check our debtors are 30,000. So, in this problem, you would be showing your debtors 30,000 in a column and 5% reserve for bad debts, you will minus reserve for bad debts 5%. So, coming to 1500, ultimately debtors being shown at 28,500 in outer column, and you are going to show your P&L account debit side. In P&L, assume this is your P&L and show it on the debit side, you will write to reserve for bad debts 1500. If you carefully analyze, the treatment is similar to that of depreciation which you have been doing. Then next is depreciation on furniture. So underline furniture so that you take it in inner column and minus 150 from furniture, because the amount is given. So directly minus 150 from furniture on the asset side as depreciation, and again take depreciation on furniture in P&L account debit side. Next, depreciation on machinery is 500. Same treatment, from your machinery minus 500 on the asset side as depreciation. Again, you will take the 500 in P&L account on the debit side to depreciation on machinery. Now, the last adjustment is closing stock. You know the rule, closing stock account debit to trading. That means trading account has to be credited. So, you will write on the credit side of your trading account as by closing stock. Second treatment would be in the balance sheet asset side, you will be writing closing stock. So, with this, you will be able to solve your fourth problem. Now, we will move on to fifth problem, and the same thing you will be doing as how we did it in fourth problem. So, any important thing, I'll put it across on the board.